Hello, I'm Martin Fenske, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Battle Brothers. So, as I said at the end of the previous episode, I traveled to Hellestad off camera. I found some locations along the way, but I didn't attack anything. I really just wanted to get to Hellestad, sell everything that we have, and join the war. So, here we are, I sold everything. We have over 50,000 now, but just barely, but it was enough. I had to sell some weapons that I wanted to keep, like the one-handed axes, but because we have like maybe two episodes to go before we switch to a new series, I just wanted to get 50,000 to complete this this ambition. So in Hellestad, well, I bought some supplies along the way, so I think we are now ready for some fighting. Let me actually check. Yeah, all the gear is basically fixed. I should probably check if anybody has or is complaining about the lack of fighting. That indeed, actually no, everyone is content. That's enough. I'll have to switch some people around, but first let's check the contracts. We have a contract from a noble house here, so I think we'll start with that. I really just want some of these war contracts. Walk into a camp, Wolf have got a room to find him surrounded by his generals. They're looking down the map where a great number of opposing tokens are facing off. The nobleman looks at you. Alsalsort, I need you to go here. He drops a stick on the map and meet with Sir Theo. We are preparing to end this war once and for all, and your help will be most crucial. You not but linger. The man raises his eyebrows, then a finger. Oh, yes. Your help will be paid for. Make no mistake about that. Okay, great battle. He straightens up. So, payment. You are to receive some money. Don't care at this point. We of course need more. And what is the actual contract? Move to war camp. Report to Sir Theo. Assist the army in their battle against House Steinwall. Accept. Okay. Pause. Where do we have to go? Down here. Probably should take our most experienced people for this. Let's see, this is fine, let's take Torvald. Maybe we don't need the surgeon for this. There. Crossbow should be good against all the armored targets. Think if I want to get take all our archers, maybe I'll leave Torvald and take Nilo instead. Yep, okay. Looks good. Now, we need to get to that camp as quickly as possible. And it almost seems like we are too late to this war. Because this really might be the last like battle of the war. If we win, it just ends. Come into Sir Theo's camp to find the man partaking in a beetle race. Really? They cheer on the beetles, which halfway down the track made the Haestra turn on one another and start fighting. So just cheer. Cheers get ever louder. Sir Theo finds you through the crowds and takes you to his stand. I'm glad you're here, Sellsword. I have something for you to do right now. Sir Theo sighs and begins to talk. I don't mean to waste your talent, Sellsword, but I need someone to go out and requisition food supplies for the army. We are running low on supplies and need all the help we can get. Oh, come on. Hey, if you're getting paid, that is no insult to you. So, where I'm supposed to go? Not exactly what I expected. Ambition fulfilled. Yep, that's what we needed. Excellent. Sounds like we found something interesting, but I don't see anything. Might be... Oh, it's just these brigands. Okay, don't care. Of course, if we were not ending the series basically tomorrow, I would do all these fights. And I'd probably use different people. I would just keep leveling our less experienced guys. But at this point, we just want to get into one big fight with another house. Come on, let's get some action here. Oh, this is what we found. This a hut. Let's wait till the morning in case they throw us into battle right away. I don't want to fight during the night. Okay, the war camp is just as you left it. You're not sure if that's good or bad. Tomorrow we'll bring Morshai to take care of you, or the Black Army to get some rest. And win this war. It'll be unmatched. Let's pick a side. Let's go with the first one. He's like a dead man and wake like one too. The sunlight slipping in the tent is too blinding to go back to bed, and the flaps are too far to shut. The hell with it, you'll get up. A young boy stands outside your tent with scroll. He unfurls and struggles to read it. Your commander has just say, better go and see him yourself. Okay, time to visit the commander. You meet Sir Theo in the stand. He looks rather excited. A shrewd and a shrouded little man stands by his side. The commander talks hurriedly. Hello, sir. So my spies tell me that House Steinwall has a much-needed shipment of equipment heading towards their camp. I need to go destroy it. Sure. Where? Route from Lichtburg to Westerholz. Where the hell is Westerholz? I'll be going this way. Are you kidding me? Well, I think I'm just gonna skip the travel, so when I get to the caravan, I'll come back, because this would just be too much traveling. So for you, this will be a second, for me probably like 10 minutes, but hopefully it doesn't destroy our morale completely. Well, it's back where we started. It's really not what I expected, but well, I'll see you in a moment. Okay, so I thought the caravan would actually go around and follow the road, but they decided to go this way and they will just cross the sea, it seems, and go directly to Westerholm. So I was able to get to them a bit faster than I expected. And yeah, let's attack them. What are they defended by? It shouldn't be anything too crazy, but I don't want you guys to miss any of these fights. So engage, and let's see how we can handle this. There are some arbalists, I think. They can be very dangerous. Here he is. Wait. And this maybe will give us a good idea how we can handle these fights with the noble houses. We start something with something simpler. Actually didn't check what was the chance to hit. I probably should do it. Let's see. 7 to 3, it's not bad. Except we just can't hit them. There we go, at least something. This guy will be a pretty high priority. Nope. 50, 55. Oh, come on, guys. There we go. Okay, I of course can't hit the arbalest. That was a good one. Okay, that's at least one problem solved. That was also a good one. Huh. Doesn't look too bad. I expected that they'll be a bit tougher. 36. Well, I guess we try our luck here. Ah. Oh, it's still fine. Okay, so now the only one left that could be a bit of a problem. Actually, there are two. These two can do a lot of damage to armor, but I think it should be fine. Yeah, they're not attacking. Can I? No, I can't kill him. Can't get to him, but he's not stunned, but has the debuff, so I don't think he'll be attacking. Okay, good. They're pretty squishy. I expected more from them. Well, that was easy. Oh, we still have to destroy those cards. We have to kill the donkey as well. Now we can say it's over. I hope that killing all these soldiers just counts as destroying the caravan. We don't have to manually finish off everything else. Okay. So, one battle is done, and again, I'll stop the recording here and return to you guys when we are back in the camp. And hopefully we'll progress to a bit more difficult fight. Okay, so we are back in the camp. Nothing happened on the way back, so let's get in. We'll see if we'll finally get an epic fight I've been looking for. You return to Sirithio and inform him of the news. He is very subdued, his thoughts consumed with what is coming tomorrow, a large decisive battle. They already decide turn in and wait for morning. Okay, there we go. Sithio walks before an assembly of his soldiers, some idle with weary faces, having not slept through the night, others still shake with jitters. Their commander calls them Are you afraid? Are you scared? It's fine. I'd be worried if you weren't. Scattered laughter lifts the mood. He continues, but right now I'm asking you not to be scared for your own hide, but instead to be scared for the lives of your countrymen, your families. They are who we fight for this day. Let us worry about ourselves tomorrow. For today, we will be men. The laughter turns into roaring cheers. Onwards, brothers, there's a battle to be won. There we go, that's what we're looking for. So what are we up against? Plethora of footmen, a few Zweihänders, lots of billmen, many arbalests, few standard bearers, few sergeants, and a few knights. To arms. So how many exactly? 40, and we have 35 on our side. So I guess we let the soldiers jump forward, hold the center, and we try to flank them. Is this mercenary? Oh, they also have mercs on their side. Okay, wait, wait. Oh, wait, they're coming from the north as well. Please don't do that. We have a target. Actually, he's out of range. Never mind. Still don't have a target. I mean, yeah, we can shoot the front line, but I'd rather wait and get something juicier than these guys with shields. Yeah, something like the Zweihänder there. Wonder how many are there coming from the north. This may take a while. Should probably focus on these guys with the long weapons. Okay, this is a target number one, I think. Wait, wait. So they're splitting up, so instead of trying to flank them, we'll just go through the middle and make sure they can never fight as one unit. Oh, there is a knight. Wait, wait, there's... Oh, that's our knight. Wait. Okay, so this shot is not blocked. Let's go. That's one. And I think this is their sergeant, is it? I'd like to get to him somehow. We could kill their sergeants early. Their morale basically just fall apart. Wait, wait. That was a good shot. That's also a good shot. It kinda sucks that we lost our arbalest too early. What is this? Is this a second sergeant here? Yeah. Okay, let's try to take out this one first. It's surprisingly tough. Okay, excellent. Oh, come on. You have so many targets and you have to shoot one of ours. I think next turn we'll have to start focusing on the crossbowmen, on these three. I could just try to go after them, but I think that would be a bad idea. There's another knight. Okay, so because our knight is moving north, we should be able to hold this, or he should be able to hold this side for a while. They are pretty tough. Let's focus on this one. Try to take him out. Engelbert, you'll have to move this way. Wait. And let's move Nilo. Ah, that's not what I wanted. Okay, whatever. Excellent. That was the plan. On. Kill him before he can shoot. There we go. Now we just have to get to the arbalest somehow. There's another one now. Perfect. He doesn't have cover, but I can't. No, I can't reach him. Oh. That's a lot of damage from the Triumph there. This guy also has to die. Because as long as he's alive, they won't break. Okay, they expect to finish him with just one hit. And that's pretty good because you'll have to start moving up to do something about this guy. Wait. Or what if I just moved away from him? One, two, three. It could get behind them. I won't be able to. Actually, I can do it this way. I can't attack this turn, but I have a pretty good position for next turn. Wait. Excellent. One, two. Don't want to move too far. Stay here. Wait, wait. Thinking about sending some help north, but then I would get exposed to all these crossbows. Eh, I'll just stay here. This should be fine. I mean, this flank is gonna fall apart at some point, but hopefully when it does, we are done in the south. I think it's time to move. Wait. That was nasty. Still can't reach that arbalest. Let's try to take out the spy hand there. Can't reach him. Can I reach the arbalest? I can. Well, I can still reach him, but now he has cover, so I probably should just switch. Can't hit this guy. Let's maybe go after the crossbowman. Nope. That's not what we needed. Now I can't attack this white hand there. I come on. I can do better than that. Can't really afford to miss too many attacks because our support really is falling apart. I don't want to move Stavarek forward as long as they have the high ground, but I may have to. Who are you? Mercenary 49-41? Great. Okay, so that's why I have to go. Oh, wait. Oops. I'm blind. There we go. Now we can move closer and we'll try to focus on that sergeant, I think. Because they have one sergeant here, then this standard bearer, and I don't think they have any more support guys after that. That was a good one. Okay, fine. We have a target for Stavarek. Let's move him forward. Yep. Actually, I don't have to be here. I'll just move back again. And if they want to fight, they will have to move closer. One, two, three. That should be enough, the people that we have on this side. Well, let's move Nidaros this way. That was a bad idea, attacking into that riposte. What is this? It's another mercenary. It's pretty good that he got the bleed on the knight with the first attack. What is this? Another merc. So they are falling apart on one side and they don't have any support. Now, can I get to the arbalest? 1, 2, 3, I can, but then I would be really exposed to all the other crossbows. That sounds like a horrible idea. This is probably not much better, it's maybe even worse, because the arbalest can still shoot. I guess next turn all our archers turn north. Oh, come on, that was pretty important attack actually. So how does it look like with us? Can someone still attack? If I move there, I won't be able to attack. But one, two, three. I'll just move and I can try to hit both of them next turn. I actually have an angle on this guy. Sure. Let's just hit one of ours. Come on, dude. Prophet, really? Are they really running away? Mercenaries giving up? That is a good sign. It doesn't look like the shot is blocked, but I'm pretty sure it is, so let's just not do that. That's another bleed. Might already be enough for the knight to bleed out. That's like, what, 10, 20, 30, that's like 50 bleed damage, I think, already on him. You have to kill that surgeon because he has a cleaver and the Sobo could end up same way as this knight, which we really want to avoid. Okay, good. We still have to stay here. No, let's just move this way. Two, three, four. This should still be safe. I want to get the first attack on the Zweihand there. Hopefully kill him before he can do too much damage. Because I think that's like the last really dangerous unit. Come on! Did he attack this turn already or no? Well, let's move at least that one tile so that you can't hit both here. I'll just move closer. Okay, please don't miss. It's 85%. There we go. again. I miss the unit. Well, let's attack now. I wanted to get to the crossbowman. It was a bit greedy. Didn't want to let him run away. You guys should be fine here. Actually, let's just move down here. We have two more targets. That probably wasn't the best idea, knocking him back and let him run away. Okay, how many are there still? 10. And out of those 10, like 4 are already fleeing. Let's move this way. There's still the knight. And I think he's dead now. He should just bleed out. Okay, it's over. Well, it was quite easy. Pretty bloody, but we barely took any damage. I think we are a bit overgeared for the war at this point. Yeah, the war is best when you get it as the first crisis, so that you can use all the gear that you get from the knights. At this point, I'm actually not sure if the knight gear would even be an upgrade. Maybe some helmets. So, wasn't really a problem to win this. Let's check the loot. If there is anything interesting even. I want to get some of the knight gear, but we didn't get anything. Yeah, this is probably the only item that is an upgrade. This one is 160. That's garbage. There was that one fancy helmet from the knight. The last unit that died, but we didn't get it. Oh well, we'll just take what we can. How much food do we have, by the way? But this battlefield is littered with the dead and those who wish they were. Cetheus' men go about collecting their wounded and killing the enemies they find. The commander himself claps you on the shoulder and flags blood splattering your neck. Good work, sir, sellsword. I wasn't sure if your men would hold their end of the bargain, but you damn well did. Your employer should be very happy to see you, I believe. Victory. Okay, can we get some supplies along the way? Perhaps you could use more food. So many locations now. Maybe you could try to attack the Sunken Stronghold as the last fight for the series. Well, at least the ground grains. But there's something than nothing. Anything here? We could buy the ammo. And just because I'm curious, at this point it doesn't really matter. Oh, there is something. Savage pole blade. Relatively thin blade and a very long shaft used for devastating attacks over some distance and to render shields invisible from behind the front line. This long axe must be the work of an extraordinary craftsman. Do we have a long axe for comparison? We do. So it doesn't have increased damage. It has a lower durability. 1310. So the armor penetration and damage to armor is the same. So shield damages. Shield damage is better. Chance to hit head is still the same, range is still the same, and it's lighter. Well, this is garbage. It's really, really bad for a unique item. Come on, let's get there before the night. There we go. So, that is our reward. And anything new? Some nice weapons, perhaps? Nope. We really didn't get a single Hedge Knight. Or maybe one throughout the whole series. Let's sell all the loot. Come on, this is about to spoil. And I'll just sell everything else off camera. It may take a while. So we have everything that we need. I'll buy all the food to make sure we don't run out. And then we have one more episode to go before the release of the Warriors of the North. So I think the closest and most interesting fight really should be the Sunken Stronghold. I checked the garrison multiple times, and every time I checked, it was a large group of skeletons with a priest, and that means there is a really high chance of like a unique item in the location. So let's try to find one more unique something. I still think that we should be able to get like better armors, that we didn't see the best there is. I mean, this one is good and this one is decent, but I think we still should be able to find better, so let's try our luck. Just because I'm curious how good the armors that we can find in the game can be. By the way, in the expansion they added some pretty interesting stuff. I saw some screenshots and yeah. It both looks pretty good, and the numbers are also pretty crazy. So I'm looking forward to unique items from the expansion. But well, that'll be tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. We'll see when exactly is the expansion is released. For today, we are done. So I hope that you like this episode. I hope that you're going to join me for the next one again. And until then, have a good time. Bye-bye.